Good morning and God bless you. We are reading from 2 Peter chapter 1 verse number 4 in the King James Version. Whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partaker of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in this world through lust. Praise God. We started the last time to talk about three steps of righteousness that every believer has to understand and go through. That day, we spoke about the imputed righteousness. That is the basis of our justifications as a believer. That our old account has been wiped out and there is a new credited account of righteousness to every believer at your union. It's like you are owing a company a large sum of money and the account was closed. And you are credited. Not that your account was left empty, but you are credited with the righteousness of Jesus Christ. Meaning, if you look at your past, it's as if you never sinned before. So you are not going to suffer any consequences of sin of your past or of your father or of your mother because the account has been closed. That is the first stage of righteousness. It's called imputed righteousness. And that's the basis of justification, that you have been justified. There is no sin in your past that's going to come back to haunt you anymore. That is the belief that Abraham had, and righteousness was credited to him. That's why it's like God can never remember that you ever did wrong. Not that I can't remember. There is no account for your wrongdoing ever when you come in union with Jesus Christ. It's so sweet, right? Then the second category, which is the one we are going to today, is called implanted righteousness. God did not only input righteousness to us as believers in our union with Christ, that is the experience of being born again, he also implanted the nature of righteousness in us. I've said this over and over. The difference between an unbeliever who is sinning and a Christian who commits sin, they are two different people. An unbeliever can live continuously without any regret about sin because to him, what he's doing is normal. But when a believer is doing what is wrong, committed sin, he knows he has a conscience that pricked him. It is the nature of God in him that is now rebelling against the lust or the iniquity that is found in him. That's why the scripture said in 1 John chapter 1 verse number 2, he said, little children, if you sin, so Christian can sin even when his account has been imputed and when his way has been planted with righteousness. He said, we are an advocate with the Father. Alright, so there's a difference between an unbeliever who is sinning and a Christian who sins. The two of them are not the same. And every believer must know that the reason why you know it, that you just lie or you just committed an abomination, you've just done something wrong, is that there is a nature that is now in you that will not be comfortable with the life of iniquity. That is divine nature. It's called implanted righteousness. So the imputed one is that God took care of your past. The implanted one is that he now empowers you to say no to sin, to resist the temptation. That's why one of my favorite scripture is in Ezekiel chapter number 36, verse number 26. When God was promising the implanted righteousness, I'd like you to hear what he said. A new heart also will I give to you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And he said here, I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you the heart of flesh. So the taking away of the Adamic nature from us is replaced with the divine nature that is able to agree easily with the righteousness terms of God under the New Testament. You are now having grace to live rightly with God. You are now having right standing and have the ability to live right as a believer. I'd like you to hear Romans chapter 6 verse number 14. It says, for sin will no longer be a master over you. That's Amplified Version. So you now have implanted righteousness, and therefore sin will no more have dominion, will no more have power over you, since you are not under the law. You are no more operating under the righteousness by law in the Old Testament. You are not under the law as a slave, but under unmerited grace as a recipient of God's favor and mercy. So every believer is gifted Hear it now, with implanted righteousness. There's something in you that want to obey God. There's something in you that want to do the will of God. And every time you do it, that's why you cannot even take credit for it. Because it's not you that is doing it. It is the implanted righteousness that now crave to do the things that pleases God. So I like you to understand that you've been implanted with the seed of righteousness. And for whatever is wrong with you now, I tell you the truth, over time, you're going to get out of it as you begin to operate under the divine nature that God has given to you. I like you to hear this. Now, the imputed righteousness is the basis for justification. The implanted righteousness is the basis for sanctification. This is what many believers do not know. So that empowerment, the divine nature, is the basis, is the ability in you to live a sanctified life. Can a believer be perfect? Yes. Can a believer live a sanctification life? Yes. Can you be holy? Yes. Why? Because you now have implanted righteousness inside of you at your being born again. The day you have Jesus coming to you, he came and implanted into you the ability to say no to unrighteousness. I'd like you to hear what the Hebrews chapter 2 and verse number 10 has to say about it in Amplified Classic. For it was an act worthy of God and fitting to the divine nature that he, for whose sake and by whom all things have their existence, in bringing many sons into glory, should make the pioneer of their salvation perfect, should bring to maturity the human experience necessary to be perfectly equipped for his office as high priest through suffering. So everything Jesus did was not only to impute righteousness to you, was also to implant the nature that he brought from heaven. So we have a new nature. That's why that scripture said we are a new creature. There's a new thing inside of you. You're a new creation. You are not the you of before that used to lie and say all kinds of things. There's something in you that is crying to obey God. And then it can never work by law. It can't work by you trying it. It begins by you obeying that you're a new person. There's a new seed inside of you. And then you begin to synchronize. And that will take us to the third one. It is called embedded righteousness. I'll talk about that tomorrow. Those three kinds of righteousness is in stages. And that's how you mature yourself to become what God wants you to be. At the beginning of teaching and talking about righteousness, many people thought what we are talking about is you can do what is wrong and you have been forgiven. No. But then it begins with you understanding that you are now under grace, not under law. Sin do no more have dominion over you. So you are a righteous man because righteousness has been putted into you. But also, you must understand that you are being planted with righteousness so that you can now be embedded with righteousness. Tomorrow, I can't wait to talk with you again. But this morning, or whenever you're listening to me, I'd like you to write as a comment, I have the divine nature of God inside of me. That's who you are. Demons cannot stay inside of you. Sickness cannot stay inside your body because you have implanted righteousness. And you have to believe it because that's what the Word of God is saying, that you should believe. And if you believe it with the gift of righteousness and the gift that there's an implanted nature of God inside of you, we escape corruption. Very easy to escape anything the enemy tried to throw at you. You turn the lemon to lemonade. Have a wonderful day. God bless you.